Creators, welcome to DaVinci Resolve 20 over 40 in 30 day 21. And today we're going to talk about using the text-based editing skills inside of DaVinci Resolve. Those of you who are familiar with apps like Descript is going to be a very similar based thing where we're going to transcribe a piece of audio and then use that guy to then in turn edit this on the timeline. I might need it for this video because already I can't speak. Without further ado, let's jump inside. We're going to click that baby, fire up the DaVinci Resolve, and let's go and create us a new project. Actually, we're an untitled project. We can work here. I am just going to drag in a piece of footage, but before, actually, I could do it here. I'll drag it on the footage. Yes, I'll go ahead and change that. We want to step back to the media pool, and once again, that's down here in the bottom, press media. So we're going to be here. What I want to do is right-click upon this area. Let's embiggen this a little bit. And down here in the bottom, we want to go to AI Tools, and we want to go to Audio Transcription. We will put Use Speaker Detection. That's important, of course, if you have multiple speakers. Even in this clip where I don't have multiple speakers, I'm still going to do that. But I want to go ahead and transcribe this guy. And you could clear any transcription or create new transcriptions or transcribe as a nested clip. I'm just going to do audio transcription and call it a day. So let's transcribe this guy. This is Doc the editor here. Hey, I want to clear something up. When I did this in the demo, I accidentally clicked on the timeline instead of clicking on the clip. So the menus are a little different. Let me show you what it looks like. Real deal, Holyfield. Let's pop back into DaVinci real fast. And then down here in the bottom, when I was clicking on, I was right-clicking on this timeline one, which was giving me odd things. What I want to do is click here, go to AI Tools, go to Audio Transcription, and then press Transcribe. So I'll clear this real quick just so that you can see. I'm going to go on AI Tools, Transcription, and then click Transcribe, and that will give us the results. Everything else in the video is exactly correct. But that part was off. Now we're going to send you back to the video so you continue listening to this donkey tell you how to get it done. The transcription speed, of course, will depend on your computer and how fast it is, so forth, et cetera. I'm on a Mac Studio Max. It has a fairly decent amount of RAM at, I believe, 48 gigs. And it's flying through that. There's no problem. And what we're going to end up with is a transcription window that pops up. And here in turn, let's embiggen this so it's easier for you to see. Here is my transcription. And I believe these little dot, dot, dots are places where I left space. So I said, we are recording test audio to see how well we can use DaVinci to take out things we say automatically based on text-based editing. Now, there's the pause. And I say, now there's an intentional pause, right? So I believe these dots are our pauses. There is a button up here that you use in order to remove the pauses. And again, my frustration with DaVinci, the text helper tools don't always say what these are. I wish they did. I wish they would make that better. Of course, this is decrease the font size, increase the font size, and use high contrast mode, things of that nature. I really don't know why there's not a text tool there, but I am absolutely positive that that guy is for removing spaces. So if we click that and you see that will pull spaces out. I'm going to undo this temporarily so we can jump over to the timeline and see what we're doing. Now, let's go to the edit page real quick. And here, if I make any changes here, nothing is happening on the timeline, right? You see how this, the timeline cursor, let me move this out the way. The timeline cursor is still staying there. But at the very top here, if I press this guy and give it a second, see if the tooltip pops up. Of course it don't. This is the transcript. This is take me back to the timeline, right? So there's that. There's that. And I really don't know why it says transcription pending, considering I already transcribed it. But that is odd. Let's go and see transcribe missing clips in the timeline. Let's go ahead and just do that again. It's really cool. You know what? I didn't even know had this happened before. But just going right here, there's always extra things to press in those ellipses, aka three dots. So I just reran the transcription and their speaker detection was there. And you can always come in and select. So right here, one of the options is remove silent portions. That's the same thing as pressing that. And then you can say create subtitles from audio. That I would do last once you're done. Of course, you can export these subtitles and you can reset the speaker data. In this particular case, I'm going to come over and label the speaker doc and fix it because there's only me talking. But yeah, let's go and mess around with removing these silent areas. Let's click that. That yanked out. And you can see on the timeline right away, there was some removal. So let me move this out the way so we can see the timeline. And I'm going to press the zoom to full extent. And you can see where the spaces are down here, right? If I'm bigging the timeline a little bit, you can see there's massive spaces. Actually, let's do this. Let's increase the audio there. And then if we hold the option key and scroll wrong direction, we can make it a little bit more obvious. Okay, so let's go and do that removal again. And now you can see we have nice tight cuts. Again, you could always space these things back out using trim edit mode, but let's go and give this a play. We are recording a test audio to see how well we can use DaVinci to take out things that we say automatically using the text-based editing. That was an intentional pause to see if there's a way to cut that out. Now, of course, after I demonstrate how to cut out this intentional pause, we don't need this. Text-based editing. All right, so you see, that's a little tight, but again, these are easy things to fix. So let me see if I can slightly move that up. I could always go to my trim tool and click on the side here and give it a little bit more space so you can hear the word. See this. Text-based. There you go. And then this one was also jumpy. Text editing. That was an intent. Okay, so we know that we don't need this section, okay? So what I'm going to do is bring this over here. And the part where I said, now that was an intentional pause to see if we could cut this out. Now, of course, after I demonstrate how to cut this, we don't need this. This is true. So let's go ahead and remove this section of the clip by just pressing backspace. All right. Now let's play the difference using the text-based editing. Text-based editing should provide you a faster way to get a good baseline edit on things that you create for YouTube, podcasts, social media clips, training courses, so forth, so on, and et cetera. Using DaVinci. Okay, so there's a little spot where I need a little space. And again, hit the slash, so forth, so on, and et cetera. Using DaVinci Resolve's AI tools, the audio transcription will allow you to simply edit the text just by editing things on the timeline, just by editing the text in the transcription editor. Okay, so I don't need this things in the timeline. Just by editing, let's run that back again. Audio transcription will allow you to simply edit the text just by... There we go. So we're going to take out just by editing things on the timeline. And we're going to remove that. And let that play a second. Will allow you to simply edit the text. There you go. Now we're going to trim this. Just listen to that. Will allow you to simply edit the text just by editing the text in the transcription editor. This should simplify your video editing process. On the important. Now, see that it's really weird how it chops it, but it's so easy to fix this. I don't mind that little bit of a chop. Now, the important thing to know is that all of this is non-destructive, so you can always go back and manually edit your footage if you need to. See, I like that part, right? And that's what I'm doing. Because it's non-destructive, I'm always able to get back parts and sections if for some reason it doesn't come out as swanky as we want. And so even if we come here and big this up and then big this a little wider, we can see this is a little muddy. So I can do things like grab the end of this piece of audio here. I'm almost grabbing it. There we go. And I can kind of pull it back a little bit so it's not as sharp of a cut when we get there. Okay, so let's go back here. Non-destructive, so you can always go back and manually edit your footage if you need to. And it's really weird to record this and take weird pauses. I normally just do a continuous line of... All right, let me undo that. Something went weird there. And it's really... Okay, let's grab this. It chopped off a little bit of my laugh. I don't want to do that. That sounds odd. And it's really weird to record this and take weird pauses because that's not how I record videos. I normally just do a continuous line of speaking, continuous line of talking, a continuous line of absolute BS. All right, so we're gonna keep that. I normally do. Let's click here and let's do that. Here, let's delete this part. And then let's listen. Normally just do a continue. All right, so let's embiggen this a little bit and clean this area up just a smidge. There we go. And then, of course, because it's in the subframe, I'm just going to do a slight audio transfer there. Just do a continuous line of absolute BS. You guys tell me which edit I should put in. Okay, so let me take this part out. I don't need that. And really weird that it kept this particular space. Let me move this transcriber window out the way and then go to the full edit. BS. Let's listen here. Let me go and record today's video. All right, so we can close this gap. I made a shortcut key for closing gap, control delete. But let's listen at it now. Absolute BS. All right, and then embiggen this just enough to clean this part up. And then, of course, we could click here and then hit that Command T to give it a little cross dissolve. And then I could pull this back like such. Let me go and record today's video. Now, let me go and record today's video in DaVinci. All right. So what we're going to do is take this portion out. We don't need that. And then let's close that. I actually like this. I mean, honestly, don't get me started. I think it's faster than doing it in Descript. BS. Now, let me go and record today's video in DaVinci Resolve 20 over 40 in 30, day 21. All right, there you go. So, I mean, it's actually relatively simple. And yeah, you do have to make some minor fixes, but the whole point is it's not supposed to do your job for you. It's just supposed to make your job easier. So
using the text-based editing.
Text-based editing. Now, one thing that you can do is we can close this now. This doesn't always work, and there's things that you can do for the jump cuts, but one of the things that you can click there and you can add the smart transition, and the smart transition sort of tries to get rid of some of that jumpy cut. This is a smooth one right here. So if you press that, that supposedly gives you a smoother cut. Definitely keep this under about 6 frames. You don't want it to be so obvious. And let's give it a second for the computer to think. And let's play this. Text-based editing should... There you go.
Using the text-based editing.
Text-based editing... All right, it got stuck there for a second because, of course, I'm recording this at the same time. Give it a second to catch up.
The text-based editing.
Text-based editing should... yeah, right now, while I'm actually recording this, it's not going to do that thing. It's going to take a minute to just render, but that's because I'm recording in the background. But that, you can just tell by rubbing over it, it is a smoother flow. And if you do one step at a time, it's a little bit of a smoother flow, so it's not as crazy when it comes to doing that jump cut. There you go, fam. I think it is well worth giving it a shot. It can at least speed up your cuts. It can allow you to make some changes in the transcription. Of course, if you edit any of the text by typing over it, for right now, it's just going to change the words when you go to create the subtitles. It's not going to change your voice yet, but there is a tool in DaVinci that can do that, and we'll talk about that in the next version of DaVinci Resolve 20 over 40 in 30. Let's call it day 22. All right, you know what it is. I don't know who needed to hear this, but if it was you, let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, press the like button, press the subscribe button, ring the notification bell so that you'll know when I make another one of these videos. I want to thank you for sticking through me for this first 22 days of making a fool out of myself as I learned DaVinci Resolve. But you know what? I just hope that this gives somebody the wherewithal to try something new, try to edit in DaVinci. And you know what? The more I play with it, I'm just going to get better. I want to implore you to do the same. I'm roughly spending, right now I'm spending about 30 minutes to an hour a day figuring it out. Of course, I have all my work and my other content that I need to create. But you know what? It's coming along easy. It's actually coming along pretty easy. Of course, if you have any questions or something you don't understand, let me know. And again, if you're looking for somebody that can just walk you through the whole thing much faster than me goofing off, go and check out Prominent Video. Go see my man, Justin Brown. His videos are amazing. Also, my buddy Daniel Battelle has DaVinci Resolve new videos on his channel. I would tell you to go check them out as well if you're trying to get up to speed really, really quickly. Right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch, and I agree with them.
I need to know everything, who and the what and the where. I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but act like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche, a 5 and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throws to turn to a ghost. I need to know everything. Now you'll be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver in silence, then let them in talk.